this bus is how old?
20. 20 years.
20 years old. It runs better than the newer buses.
Oh, yeah. Miles better.
The XED35,
the turn is excellent.
Is it the turning radius is nice and tight?
Turning radius is excellent. Other buses, some turn you make.
Oh, wow.
You're climbing the sidewalk. This one,
not at all. Oh, that's fantastic. That's awesome.
Although it's 20 years old, it doesn't rattle. You know, when you're riding all the buses, the bus is a book. I mean, you hear it. See, it's good.
Yeah.
Now the transmission on those those bus was very expensive.
Oh God, yeah. I think it's a Z. I think it's a Voice actually.
But now my brother was a mechanic, a supervisor.
Yeah.
Mechanic at Connecticut Transit. Those transmissions were so expensive. They cost $25,000 alone for the transmission.
Oh my God.
But those buses ran just than you want to have a transmission.
Yeah.
And then they end up getting the flyers.
The new flyers.
And those were $43, $44 series. Those were a piece of crap.
Yeah.
At a certain miles an hour when they hit a bump, the whole front start wobbling.
Yup. Yeah, it's...
And then it'll have a little sway to it after a certain miles an hour.
Yeah. These will run circles around those any day.
Yeah. For me, the best bus, although it was old, but it ran like hell, was the GMC.
The GMs, oh, of course. Nothing beats a GM.
Big thing underneath, you know?
Yeah. get Elon Musk on the phone.
Elon Musk, yo, why y'all haven't come up with a silicon battery?
Yeah, right.
Instead of the smooth, big, fat thing on the
phone. Make millions.
And then you have part of it as solar.
Yeah.
How many charges that you don't
have? A little slow recharge, yeah.
Yeah, slow recharge. Slow
yeah,
recharge.
Like while you're driving, yeah. That would, yeah.
That's a lot slower than
possible. I stop at the rest stop and talk to one of those Tesla.
Yeah.
And I asked him, I said, how long does it take to fully charge the battery? They're telling me 3 hours. So, you go to a rest stop and you sit there 3 hours to get a full charge on the Tesla.
Like,
yeah, like 3 hours all for nothing. Like,
yeah,
you know,
that's what I'm saying. With that cylinder, you pull up,
you just stick it in
one,
and go.
Shove the other one in, and you go.
I don't like you're gonna need. There should be a way that you can get a portable battery, make it charge on the way instead of having to rely on those chargers that you're probably not even gonna get in the gas.
Have a charger. Have a charger for the cylinders. Yeah.
Like sometimes I see like stores like we want to like, get some groceries. And stuff.
Manufacturers out of business.
I mean, we're in a rush. I was watching a movie the other day. It was one of those end of the world movie.
Yeah.
And lo and behold, asteroids coming, it's knocking every house down in the neighborhood. Everybody's running, grabbing their stuff.
Yeah.
And the guy have a Tesla. He put his family in the Tesla.
And all
now he got to start it. He got to get it. He have it on his phone. He's searching for Wi-Fi. Trying to get. Just to get the car started. Got started.
There
it is. They're on the highway and lo and behold at the rest stop. You got people getting gas and you got the Tesla, the electric car. Everybody's waiting for the charge. The guy go inside, this man put down his keys, right, for his gas car.
Yeah. You'd be damn near screwed.
Yeah.
Worth it.
You just passed the deal.
question. Have you rode a Gillig Phantom before? Like the Gillig Phantoms, like the ones that look a little bit like a Ryan 5, but they're owned by Gillig. They have Suburban and regular configurations.
lot of the time, the drivers, we shoot those buses down.
Yeah.
But to me, management was